गुड आफ्टर
ओके यू कैन टाइप योर अटेंडेंस नाउ ओके देन व्हाट वी आर डिस्कसिंग I think we are discussing about multiplication of fractions, is it? Okay. Then, how will you multiply a fraction with a whole number? How will you multiply a fraction yes, with a whole number?
Whole number?
Whole number into numerator.
Whole number into numerator. Whole number into numerator.
Is this whole number is numerator? Numerator is the product of whole number and numerator. And denominator is keeping as same.
Same.
Okay. Then we have discussed about example 5 in page number 35. Is it? And then you can see that there is exercise 2.2. I have asked you to match the following question. That is first two questions. Did you get the answer?
Yes.
Okay. Then shall we discuss about the answers? First one is you have given some products and some pictures. You have to find the correct product according to the pictures. Then 2 into 1 by 5. Which picture represents 2 into 1 by 5? Which picture represents Joanna? In page number 36, exercise 2.2, first question. In that question, which picture represents 2 into 1 by 5? Okay, Delvin.
Fourth one, D.
D question. Oh, D picture. Okay, good. Then, what about second? 2 into 1 by 2? Okay, Harinam.
B.
B, B, B. 2
into 1 by 2 is B. Then, what about 3 into 2 by 3? Just as?
First one, no, sir.
2 into? Sorry, 3 into 2 by 3 is first one.
Yes.
Then, what about 3 into 1 by 4?
C.
That is
C.
C. Okay, that's good. In similar way, the second question can be written also. First one is 3 into 1 by 5 is equal to 3 by 5. Which one represents 3 into 1 by 5 is equal to 3 by 5? Which one? Okay, Harinan.
C. Yeah.
C. 3 into 1 by 5 is equal to 3 by 5. Good. Then what is 2 into 1 by 3 equal to 2 by 3? 2 into 1 by 3 equal to A.
Okay. A, first one.
3 into 3 by 4 is equal to 2. 1 by 4 is B.
B.
B. Second.
Okay, latecomers, please mark your attendance and please turn on your camera.
Turn on your camera.
Okay. Then, in the similar way, we can find the answers of 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. They are very simple. Look at your third question. Multiply and reduce to lowest form and convert into a mixed fraction. How will you multiply a whole number with a fraction? We have already discussed about multiplying a whole number with a fraction. Is it? Yes. Then,
yes.
First question is 7 into 3 by 5. How will you multiply page number 36? Exercise 2.2, question number 3. And among that, the first question is 7 into 3 by 5. How will you multiply 7 into 3 by 5? How will you
multiply?
And though?
Question only for now.
Page number 36, exercise 2.2, our question number 3. And there is a first question, that is seven into 3/5. 7 into 3/5. This is our first question. How will you find the answer of 7 into 3/5? Yeah,
seven into three. Denominator 5.
Okay, then what is the answer?
21 by 5.
Okay, this is a mixed fraction, is it? Oh, sorry, it's an improper fraction.
Okay. Yes.
Then, in our question, we are requested to convert to a mixed fraction. How will you convert this to a mixed fraction?
21 divided by 5.
5. Then, do it first. As we know, 4 fives are 20, is it? 4 fives are 20. That's why the whole number part should be 4. And there is, after 20, to reach 21, we need one more. That is, the remainder should be 1 and the denominator is 5. That is, 21 by 5 is equal to 4 1 by 5, not 41.
1 by 5.
Not 41 by 5, it is 4 1 by 5, okay? Okay. Then, in this way, how will you find 4 into 1 by 3? Our second question is 4 into 1 by 3. 4 into 1 by 3. What is this answer?
4 by 3.
It is 4 by 3. And then, how will you convert this to a mixed fraction? Sorry, a mixed fraction?
4 divided by 3.
4 divided by 3.
It is an improper fraction. We have to convert this to a mixed fraction. How will you convert this?
Divide.
Okay, then. How many times we can reduce 3 from 4?
One time.
So, our whole number part is 1.
One.
And what is the remainder?
1.
Reminder is one. Also 1. And 1 by 3 is 4 by 3. Is it?
Yes.
Okay. Similarly, what's our third question? 2 into 6 by 7. So our third question. How will you multiply 2 into 6 by 7? 2 into 6 by 7.
12 by 6, 7.
That is 12 by 7. Okay, now we get an improper fraction. Then, how will you change this improper fraction to a proper mixed fraction?
7 divided by 12.
12 divided by 7. Then, we know that 2 sevens are 14. And so, only 1 seven can be taken as the whole number. So, our whole number part is 1. Is it? And there should be a remainder of, what is the remainder?
5.
Remainder of 5. So 1/5 by 7 is the mixed fraction form of 12/7. Okay. Then can you do the remaining? I think there are 10 questions among only 3 you are solved and 7 remaining. Can you solve them?
Yes.
Okay, then do it as your homework. And moving to your next question. What is the fourth question? You have
to shade.
You have to do some shades, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yes. There is 3 pictures given and first one and the chain there. What we have to do in the first? 1/2 of the circle in a box. How many circles are there in the box A?
12
circles in that box. And we have to do half of the circles in the box. How will you find half of 12? 1/2 of 12?
12 divided by 2.
12 divided by 2 or 1/2 into 12. That is 1 by 2 of, we have already studied about the operator of using instead of multiplication. So we have to multiply 1 by 2 with 12. While multiplying, we get the answers. What is the half of 12?
6.
It is 6. Six. Then you have to shade 6 circles out of that square or that circle. Please shade 6 circles in your textbook, Joel. Textbook page number 37. Okay. Okay, did you complete?
Yes, miss.
Okay. Yes, miss. Then shall we move to our second one? Okay. In second question, 2 by 3 of triangles in the box B. How many triangles are there in the box B?
9.
9 triangles.
Nine.
We have to shade 2 by 3 of 9. What is 2 by 3 of 9? How will you calculate 2 by 3 of 9?
6 and 9.
2 by 3 into 9 is 2 by 3 of 9. Then, what is 2 by 3 of 9?
6.
This 8. 2 by 3 into 9 is 6. So, six. You have to shade six triangles in box B. Did you complete? Okay. Then shall we move to our third question? The third question is 3 by 5 of the squares in the box C. How many squares are in the box C?
15.
It is 15 squares are in the box C. So we are requested to shade 3 by 5 of the squares in box C. How will you find 3 by 5 of 15?
3 by 5 into 15.
Yes, that's it. 3 by 5 into 15. Then find the value of 3 by 5 into 15. What is 3 by 5 into 15? 9?
Yes, 9, 5, 45.
Then you can shade 9 squares out of 15 squares. That is 3 by 5 of 15 is 9. That's why we have to shade how many squares? 9 squares.
9.
Okay. Then, moving to our next question. Did you complete it?
Yes, miss.
Yes.
Okay, do it first, others. Heaven and Jeeva, please turn on your camera. Okay, then what is the fifth question? There are, I think, 8 questions for you to find 1 by 2 of 24, 46, 2 by 3, 18 and 27. Is it? Sorry. 1 by 2 of 24 and 46, 2 by 3 of 18 and 27, 3 by 4 of 16 and 36, 4 by 5 of 20 and 35. How will you find 1 by 2 of 24? For finding 1 by 2 of 24, we have to?
24 by 2.
1 by 2 into 24. We are using the operator of here. Joanna, do you have any doubt in this?
12.
Okay. Then, what is the 1 by 2 of 24?
12.
1 by 2 of 24 is 12. How will you get 12? By multiplying 1 by 2 with the which number?
24.
Okay. Then, like that way, can you complete the remaining?
Yes.
They are very simple. Then do it as your individual homework rather than your group work. Okay. I have already assigned group work for you, but I don't make groups. I will make it at last of this hour. Okay. Okay. Then the remaining question number 5, 6, 7, and 8 are individual homework for you. Please mark it as your homework. And also we have in question 3, the 7 questions are remaining. They are also give you as a homework. Please mark them.
Take care one.
Question number 3 is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And question numbers 5, 6, 7, and 8, page number 37. Okay. Then shall we move to our next session? Our next session is multiplication of fraction by a fraction. I think in our first class we have discussed about multiplication of fraction by a fraction. Is it?
Yes, miss.
In the case of multiplicating a whole number with a fraction, that is, I am multiplying 2 with 1 by 2. What would be the answer? What would be the answer of 2 into 1 by 2?
2 by 2.
Is 2 by 2. And 2 by 2 is 1 itself. And we know that any number can be represented as in the form of a fraction by putting the denominator 1. Is it? Any integer or whole number can be represented as a fraction by putting the denominator as 1. So I'm going to replace this 2 by 2 by 1. 2 by 1. We know that 2 by 1 is 2 itself. Is it? Okay.
Yes.
Then 2 by 1 into 1 by 2 is equal to, what is the answer? What is the answer? We know that the answer is 2 by 2. Is it? 2 by 2. How will you get 2 by 2?
Yeah.
Yes?
ചെറുതായിട്ടേ കേൾക്കുന്നുള്ളൂ
എന്തോ
മിസ് സംസാരിക്കുന്ന ചെറുതായിട്ടേ കേൾക്കുന്നുള്ളൂ എന്ന്
മൾട്ടിപ്ലൈഡ് 2 ബൈ 1 വിത്ത് 1 ബൈ 2 ദെൻ വി നോ ദാറ്റ് 2 ബൈ 1 ഇൻടു 1 ബൈ 2 ഈസ് 2 ബൈ 2 ദെൻ മൈ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ഈസ് ഹൗ വിൽ യു ഗെറ്റ് ദ ന്യൂമറേറ്റർ ആൻഡ് ഡിനോമിനേറ്റർ ആസ് 2 While multiplying two fractions, what we are actually doing?
2 into 1 and 1 into 2.
Yes, that's it. By multiplication of two fractions, we have to multiply the denominators and the numerators. The results numerator should be the product of two numerators, and the results numerator should be the product of two numerators. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Addition appa denominator same aakkanam illarunna. Addition.
That's not required in multiplication. That's only needed in addition and subtraction. It is not required in multiplication. Okay. So first we have studied the multiplication of a whole number with a fraction, and then we have learned the multiplication of two fractions, is it?
Yes.
Okay, then what would be the answer of 3 by 2 into 4 by 5? How will you multiply 3 by 2 into 4 by 5?
3 into 4.
3 into 4, 2 into 5.
12 by 10.
Would be 3 into 4, is it?
3 into 4, 12.
3 into 4. And what is the denominator? It is the product of 2 and 5.
2 into 5.
Okay. 2 into 5. Then what would be the answer?
10.
10.
10.
12 by 10, is it?
12.
Yes.
Equal to 12 by 10. Can you reduce this 12 by 10 into simpler form? reduce 12 by 10 into simpler form?
6 by 5.
Okay, it is 6 by 5. Because both 12 and 10 are multiples of which number? 2. That's why we can reduce 12 by 10 into 6 by 5. Is it clear? So, you can see in your textbook, there are some examples for getting this idea. This is very simple. We don't have to move more complex way. This is very simple way. You have to identify the way. You have to find the product of two fractions. Is it? Then you just read out the pages 38. Page number 38 after the class. And do you have any doubt? Please ask me. I think that is much complex way. They explained about the multiplication of two fractions. Okay.
Miss, ഒരു ചെറിയ example വന്നിട്ട് ഒന്ന് പറഞ്ഞിരോടേ.
പറയാം. Look at your textbook page number 39. Page number 39. There is a box. Try this. Can you see that?
Yes, miss.
Okay. Then we are requested to fill in the blanks. What is the first question? 1 by 2 into? 1 by 2 into?
1 by 7.
Then?
By 7.
Okay, then the numerator is given as 1 into 1 and the denominator is given as 2 into 7. Then what would be the answer? It's equal to?
1 by 14.
1 by?
1 by 14.
1 by 14. Then you can fill this in your textbook also. 1 by 14. Then, what is the second one? Second question is 1 by 5 into 1 by 7. 1 by 5 into?
Number
39. Page number 39, there is a box. You can see the, try these. 1 by 5 into 1 by 7. What is the product of 1 by 5 into 1 by 7? You can
one by the
two blanks columns are given. What would you write in first column?
1 into 1 and 5 into 7.
1 into 1 divided by 5 into 7. Then, what should be the answer?
1 by 35.
It should be 1 by 35. Okay, very good. Then what about the third question? Third question is 1 by 7 into 1 by 2. Then, how will you write in the first column?
1 into 1 and 7 into 2.
Okay,
1 by 7 into 2.
The answer would be?
1 by 14.
Yes, it is the same given as, and the order is just changed. That is, in first question, 1 by 2 into 1 by 7, and here 1 by 7 into 1 by 2. So, order does not matter while multiplying two fractions. Is it?
Commutative.
Commutative property. Very good. Then, in the same way, it is given as 1 by 7 into 1 by 5. That we have already find the answer as 1 by 35. And you just write it as 1 into 1 divided by 7 into 5 is equal to 1 by 35. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Do you have any doubt?
It's a simpler formula.
Simpler form. Okay. In the previous question, we have simplified 12 by 10, is it? 12 by 10. First, we have to look if 12 and 10 are multiples of 2. We have to start with 2. Okay. You just check 12 and 10 are multiples of 2. we get 12 and 10 are multiples of 2. We know that 12 and 10 are multiples of 2. And how many 2s are 12? How many 2s are 12?
6.
6, 6.
6 2s are 12, is it?
Yes.
So, we just write our numerator as 6. And how many 2s are 10?
5.
That's why we have replaced 12 by 10 is equal to 6 by 5. And for another example, the question given for you is that 12 by 15. Consider 12 by 15. Look at 12 and 15. Is both 12 and 15 are multiples of 2?
No.
No, 15 is 3. Not a multiple of 2. So we can't choose 2. And then we are looking at the next number, that is 3. We know that both 12 and 15 are multiples of 3. Yes.
4 by 3.
Yes, then how many 3s are 12?
4.
4 3s are 12. And how many 3s are 15?
5.
5 3s are 15. And this is the simpler form of 12 by 15. Is it clear now?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Yes.
Then shall we move to our next example? That is in page number 39. You can see there is an example 6 given. So shall we read 1/3 part of a book in 1 hour? How much part of the book will be read in 2 1/5 hours? What is the question? Sushant reads how many part of the book in 1 hour?
1/3
part of a book. Then 1/3 part of 1, is it? One book can be considered as one whole. That is, what is the 1/3 of 1? How will you find 1/3 of 1?
1 × 1.
Okay.
Equal to 1/3.
You have to replace the operator of, is it?
Yes.
Then how will you change this? 1/3
into 1/1.
Is it? So?
Yes.
What is the product of 1/3 and 1?
1/3.
It is 1/3 itself. So, how 1/3 part of a book is read by whom? Sushant, is it? Sushant reads 1/3 part of a book in 1 hour. Then there is a mixed fraction given, that is 2 1/5. How will you change this into an improper fraction? 2 1/5?
11 by 5. Numerator.
11 by 5. Can you reduce it into simpler form? Can you?
No.
This is the form of 11 by 15. We can't reduce it. So, we know that 11 by 5 hours. Just a minute. We have to find in 11 by 5 hours how many, what was the question? How much part of the book will be read in 2 1/5 hours? That is, how much part of the book will be read in 11 by 5 hours? We know that in 1 hour, he is reading 1/3 part of the book. And to find the part of the book in 11 by 5 hours, what we have to do? In 1 hour, he is reading 1/3 portion of that book. Okay. Then in 2 hours, how many portion of his that book he will read? In 1 hour, it is 1/3. Then in two hours, it should be
2 × 1/3.
2 × 1/3. That's equal to 2/3 part.
2/3.
Then in 3 hours, what happened? 1 by 3 into
3
which is equal to 3 by 3. A book is completely reading. Okay. And then similarly in 11 by 5 hours, how many parts would he read? In 2 hours, it should be 1 by 3 into 2. In 3 hours, it should be 1 by 3 into 3. Then in 11 by 5 hours, what should be the portion? Look at here. In 2 hours, we just multiply 2 with 1 by 3. And in 3 hours, we just multiply 3 with 1 by 3. And in 4 hours, what happened? It should be 1 by 3. Into 4. That's equal to 4 by 3. Then, in 11 by 5 hours, what happens? What happens?
3 into 11.
Yes, 3 into? Is it 3 or 1 by 3?
1 by 3.
1 by 3 into 11 by 5.
Yes, that's it. 1 by 3 into 11 by 5. And you know how to find the product of two fractions. That is 1 by 3 into 11 by 5. What is the product? What is the product? Numerators are 1 and 11. And the denominators are 3 and 5. Then what is the product?
11 by 15.
11 by 15. 15. So he will read 11 by 15 part of that book in 11 by 5 hours, is it? Okay. Then take your textbook page number 40. Page number 40. There is a figure 2.10 is given. Can you see that?
Yes.
Yes, miss.
Yes.
How many part of that figure is shaded?
Two.
Proper division. Is it a proper division?
Mixed.
It should be a mixed fraction. Then, what is the representation of that mixed fraction? What is that?
2 by 4.
Is this 2 by 4? Actually, there are only 3 divisions, is it? I'll just draw it out. Actually, there is only 3 divisions and 1 by 3 portion is shaded. And that 1 by 3 portion is again divided into 2. That is half of the portion 1 by 3. Is it? What is half of the portion 1 by 3? How will you write half of 1 by 3? Half of 1 by 3 is equal to?
1 by 2 into 1 by 3.
Then what is the answer? It is 1 by 6, is it?
Yes.
Okay, we have only one more minute remaining. Latecomers, please confirm you have marked your attendance. Okay. So, to multiply two fractions, the numerator should be product of numerators and denominator should be product of denominators. That's enough. While multiplicating two fractions. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, that's enough.